السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد من على الأنبياء تقدم، وكان أفصح العالمين منطقا إذا تكلم، سيدنا ونبينا أبا القاسم محمد. اللهم يا ربنا زده شرفا وكرما وتعظيما وإجلالا وقدرا، وصل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. الحمد لله الذي خلقنا مسلمين، وشرفنا بأن نكون مع الحبيب المصطفى عليه أفضل الصلاة والتسليم. والحمد لله الذي هدانا للإسلام، وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. فيا عباد الله، اتقوا الله فيما أمر، وانتهوا عما نهى عنه وزجر. ونشهد أن سيدنا، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا مثيل له في علو شأنه وعظيم سلطانه، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله، أرسله رحمة للعالمين وجعله شفيعًا للمذنبين، وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، خاصة إلى خلفائه الراشدين أبا بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجلي، وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون، اتقوا الله فيما نهى عنه، واتقوا الله فيما أمرنا به. وقد أمرنا الله عز وجل في كثير من المواقف أن نكون متحدين، متعاونين، مؤمنين، مسلمين، موحدين. قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم: واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا. إن الله لا يحب المتفرقين. الله سبحانه وتعالى هو مؤمن believers. There are many issues that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in Holy Quran that unite. Allah likes unity, likes people to come together. He doesn't like people to run away from each other. Where he said, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا, hold tight to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what is the rope? It's not a physical rope. Is a rope that everyone holding it, he will be saved. Allah described that rope in Holy Quran by saying, إن كنتم تحبون الله, if you really like him, love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, love his rope. If you love Allah, you love his rope. You love his orders. إن كنتم تحبون الله, Allah is saying to Prophet to say to the mu'min, to the believers, to the Muslims, if you really love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فاتبعوني فاتبعوا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه. Whatever Prophet gave to you, take it. Allah said in the Holy Quran, وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا. Whatever he told you to take, take. Don't use your mind to judge, I take it or I don't take it. If it is Islamic, follow it. Don't put doubts in your mind and in the mind of other people. Allah doesn't like doubts. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اجْتَنِبُوا كَثِيرًا مِّنَ الظَّنِّ. O believers, O mu'min, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, he said, O mu'min, those who say shahada, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله are مؤمن. أو مؤمن, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اجتنبوا. أو مؤمن, try to avoid كثيرا من الظن. Try to avoid the doubts. Too many of the doubts are wrong. إن كثيرا من الظن is too much of doubting. Might be you doubt something which might be correct, but most of them Allah is saying in Holy Quran are incorrect. اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن إن بعض الظن is. Some of these doubts will take you to sin. So why we have to doubt? If we see something straightforward, we follow. اتباع. Allah ordered us to follow Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, not anyone else. And what Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, what is religion? The whole religion is الدين النصيحة. Religion is advice. Means Islam is advice. Means Iman is advice. Means Ihsan is advice. So we have to take an advice of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in Holy Quran and what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying in the hadith. In الدين النصيحة, قالوا لمن يا رسول الله. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, religion, our religion is advice. Sahaba, they said, to whom? Advice, I want to advise you or myself. Advise myself on what? Advise you on what? Or advise each other on what? He said to first to advise each other on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The advice must take you to the way of Allah that He likes. To unite. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. Hold tight to the rope of Allah, all of you. وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Don't separate, make groups. Then enemy is, we are very efficient target for enemies when we are splitting. And I mean by enemies here, shaitan. We are very strong target. He attack us immediately when we are separated. He throw doubts. And Allah saying, don't doubt. And what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, in the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه وأرضاه قال, he said, Abu Hurairah, that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إياكم والظن. إياكم, I'm warning you to doubt anyone. Allah said in Holy Quran, don't doubt. Too many doubts are might be wrong. Might be one correct, two correct, but not everything. Most of them are wrong. And Prophet said what he's saying, إياكم والظن. I'm warning you. be aware not to fall into the trap of shaitan by having doubts. فإن الظن أكذب الحديث. Zan, doubts, is the most top of speeches.
Untruth.
Zan is the most speech that it is not true, untruth. Whenever you have doubt, you are trying to justify it in your mind. Make sure that you don't doubt, because doubt is going to make everyone falling into the untruth, falling with shaitan. وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا, he said, don't spy on each other. Allah will curse us. Allah doesn't like people to spy on each other. This is what he did. What he did with this one, or that one, what he did. Try to veil. If you see something wrong from your brother, veil it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of his beautiful names is As-Sattar, the veilers, the veiler. That veil all our mistakes. Allah expose our mistakes? No. Might be in day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his rahmah will not expose our mistake. He is the veiler, he is As-Sattar, the one who veils everything. He is Allah, one of his beautiful name, he's telling us, I'm As-Sattar, I am the one that I veil your mistakes, veil the mistakes of your brothers. Islam is to veil each other, not to go and expose, this one did this, this one did that. Forgive. If you forgive, Allah will forgive us. وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا, don't spy each on each other. وَلَا تَحَسَّسُوا, وَلَا تَنَافَسُوا, don't try to get jealous and try to compete with your brothers, take their businesses. Open something special for yourself after learning from your brother that what you have to do, you go and open the similar business and try to take his customers. Allah doesn't like that. Someone open a company, teach you to how to deal with it, then you go and open another company similar after you learned from him and using his name. Allah likes that. وَلَا تَحَاسَدُوا, don't get jealous from each other. What Allah wrote for you in the day of promises, you are going to get. If it is not for you, you will never get it. Don't think that you, what is in your hand is for you. It's Allah put it in your hand. If Allah takes it, it's written. If Allah put it, it's written. So don't try to get jealous from each other. If Allah make one rich, one poor, Allah has wisdom in that. Some pious person, they asked him this question. Why Allah made someone rich and someone poor? First of all, to ask that question is not allowed, it's not acceptable. It's ma la yani, it's not your business. It's Allah's will. But that man is a wise man, he answered. If the poor Allah gave him, make him rich, he might run from Islam. And Allah gave the rich man, if he didn't give him and make him poor, he will run also from Islam. So he gave him that one rich, he will doesn't run away, and this one poor doesn't run away, because he is, that poor has the capacity of accepting his poverty, that rich has the capacity to accept his richness. So both of them, they are on the right track. And Allah said, وَلَا تَبَاغَدُوا. Don't hate each other. You see, your friend booming successfully, you hate him. Why you are hating him? Because he eats better? Food is from here to here. This big. That's what you are eating. From here to here. After here, all the food is the same. No taste, nothing. Only the taste is on the tongue here. That's what all the sickness, all the problems comes from this mouth, from this tongue. Tongue make you to doubt. Tongue make you to speak bad about others. If you keep your tongue, you keep yourself. You see people, they are living on tubes, is not? They inject in their stomach food. Has taste? Has no taste. But all food is like that, from here to your belly. This only small part, if you are able to control it, you control yourself. You control your ego. وَلَا تَبَاغَدُوا. Don't hate each other. وَلَا تَدَابَرُوا. Don't turn your back to each other. You see your brother, say assalamu alaikum, even if you have problem with him. Don't make a hate, increasing hate between each other. وَكُونُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانًا. If you do like that, you'll be Allah's servant, brothers and sisters. Allah will be happy with us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us more. And Ibn Umar said, son of Sayyidina Umar said, that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Muslimu Akhul Muslim. You are my brother, and I am his brother. So you are his brother. And everyone, Muslims are brother. He didn't say mu'min. He said Muslim, because Muslim is more general. Mu'min, not everyone is really perfect mu'min. But Muslim, everyone is perfect Muslim. لا تقولوا آمنا. Allah said in Holy Quran, قولوا أسلمنا. Don't say we are mu'min. Say we are Muslim. Yes, yes, correct. Until iman enter your heart, then you are mu'min. Means until what we have discussed of the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you apply it, you are a mu'min. If you don't apply it, it will be a struggle between us and our ego to apply it, inshallah, in the future. But the intention is to try to apply it. Because Allah said, whatever Prophet gave you, follow. Don't leave it behind. And Prophet said, Al-Muslim, Al-Muslimu Akhul Muslim. Muslim is the brother of Muslim. La yazlimu. He must not oppress him. Don't speak about your brother wrong things. Means about Muslims, wrong things. Make sure you keep with them a rope of love and respect. Then you will be safe, dunya and akhirah. من كان في حاجة أخيه كان الله في حاجته. Who will help his brother? Allah will help him. Anything is a help. Anything you do to your brother to make him happy is a help. And Allah will help us for that in the day of judgment. وَمَنْ فَرَّجَ عَنْ مُؤْمِنٍ كَرْبَةً فَرَّجَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ بِهَا كَرْبًا مِنْ كُرُوبِ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Who will help his brother to feel happy and to open for him a place that less difficulties, make him to feel no more difficulty, take his burden away, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take our burden in the day of judgment away. وَمَنْ سَتَرَ مُسْلِمًا سَتَرَهُ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ And who veil a Muslim, cover his mistakes, Allah will cover your mistakes in the day of judgment. Narrated by متفقنا بخاري and Muslim, and the hadith before was by Muslim. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المستغفرين فيا فوزا للمستغفرين أستغفر الله. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة شأن صفيه فقال عز وجل من قائل مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الناهي أمته عن دار الجحيم مفخر العرب والعجم مولانا ومولى العالمين المحترمين سيدنا أبي القاسم محمد يا أيها المشتاقون نور جماله والمحتاجون شفاعته صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات واغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأعز كلمة هذا الدين وأذل الشرك والكافرين إنك على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون سلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم السلام.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد.